Dr. Gopal, your clarification. I read somewhere that even though the LMC, as on the last point, you do a degree in a foreign university, come back, you don't have to write the exam. The paper said, even if the LMC bill is passed, people who are studying in Belgium and Russia will still have to write the test and then only start practicing in India. Your clarification.
Sir, this is very important. Whatever shared my views, the previous LMC bill, then there is a hectic representation given by the all the individual states, Tamil Nadu. Especially if you have to congratulate Dr.K. Kamraj, there is a special dissent note is given by the Dr. Kamraj, strongly opposes all the views. Then likewise also the Andhra people, counterpart. Then Karnataka, Hyderabad strongly condemn this. And Maharashtra, not they are condemning certain issues, they are accepting certain issues. What I am saying, after considering the dissent raised by the state government, they have modified the bill. I will not go into the details of the modification that has been done by the bill.
Karnataka, you said that they have opposed, but Karnataka has very quietly passed the clinical establishment bill. Now, many small clinics in Bangalore and Shimoga and Coorg and all are suffering because of this.
Yes, sir. That's it.
Everything is.
Yes, sir. There is a national. Now we are nowhere on the white collar job, sir. We are nowhere on the highly respectable. You are not considered as a demigod. Remember that.
We don't want that.
Yes, because the thing is, every action being questioned, every action being suspected, every aspect being question raised by the common public. That is very important, these things. That's why Clinical Establishment Act has come. We cannot small nursing homes and medium homes cannot run the show. We go through the Clinical Establishment Bill. That is also hectic, sir. That is also hectic. So many.
Clinical Establishment Act, thank you. This is a series. I will put up one X-ray. I want the audience to talk about it. Next slide. Next. I thank Anuradha Clinic and Surya Hospital. Next. Next slide, please. I thank my guru. Next slide. Okay, this is the X-ray. What do you think is happening here? Any member of the audience except neurologist can answer. Yeah, I thought the name. Okay, what do you think is happening here? Varol Sari. Next. Lip is on the skin. It's a skin suture. I am so much than a mind. Surgery money must stick lip over to head on the board. What is that level that you see? Next slide, please. X-ray should be actually read like this. Lip is on the skin. It's a fluid level, obviously. There is a burrow, it's a fluid level. And the fluid in the male ethereum is here, and the little bit of shadow you see inside his brain. What is happening is this is a subdural hematoma which has been evacuated. Now, why we take this X-ray, I'll explain to you. Go to the next slide. This is a subdural hematoma. Of course, all these pictures are from various patients. I've compared it so that I can tell you. Concave, that is the lunar face lateral upper condition, is a subdural hematoma. Next slide, please. Commonly, we put a burr ball at the side and evacuate it. Once we evacuate it, there is a lot of free space inside. The air inside the theater, which is usually at 18 degrees, 20 degrees, will enter the skull. And then when you suture and send the patient to the first operative ward or his room, the air will expand because the temperature there is 10 degrees higher than the theater. And that itself will cause compression. Next. So the patient will not wake up, So the patient will not wake up immediately. So commonly what we do is we ship the patient to the post-operative ward. And we try to quantify it. Initially, of course, after the doing the evacuation, we do a CT scan just to see if there is any more hematoma inside. This is a common picture that all subdural hematoma post-burrow patients, we will see that there is a lot of air. the number of ways in which we remove the air, either by giving the oxygen by face mask or hyperbaric or pressurized, etc. What is happening is the air that you see inside, although it is normal air, normal atmospheric air contains 70% nitrogen, only 30% is oxygen. So the idea is if you give pure oxygen through the face mask or a positive pressure ventilation, some of this oxygen which seeps into the body will go and combine with the nitrogen present in this area of air and try to pull it out, and the rest of the oxygen will get absorbed into the brain and come out. So this is how we give over 48 hours, 72 hours. But daily CT scan monitor compared. So daily we do the X-ray to repeat what is happening. Next slide, please. So over a period of time, this fluid level will keep coming above and above. And finally, when you see minimum of air shadow, you send the patient home. Thank you.